steal you with mine. Hey guys, so for today's video, I'm gonna be doing some DIY school supplies. I know I did a video like this last week, but I seriously have so many ideas for you, so I wanted to do just one more. So if you're new here, be sure to click that subscribe button down below. Also, I'm having a giveaway going on right now. I'm sure you guys already know about it, but just in case you don't, the main rules that you have to be a subscriber, I'll have the video link down below with all the information. But you can like potentially win headphones and tapestry and a backpack, so if you wanna enter that, be sure to do so and subscribe, and I'm gonna go ahead and get started. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with printed notebooks just because they are super easy to make and you don't really need a lot of things for them. So for most of these DIYs, I'm using sticker paper, but if you don't wanna get that, you could just use regular paper and Mod Podge. I just like the quality of sticker paper better and it's a lot easier to use. So the first one is this Two Eggs Over Yeezy notebook, and this is inspired by a wall hanging I saw in one of Lauren Elizabeth's videos because I'm like obsessed with her. But anyways, I just printed off this image on sticker paper and trimmed it out and then put it on this yellow notebook, and I just love it because those little composition notebooks are so cheap and I think this is just like a really fun way to dress it up, and it's so easy. Now this next one is basically the same concept, but I just want to show you guys what to do if you don't want to get sticker paper and you just want to do regular paper and Mod Podge. So I printed out this and it just says my unicorn ate my homework because I just love that. And all I did was trim it out and then coat the notebook top in Mod Podge, and then I just placed this over top. I was really bad at cutting this, by the way. Definitely like make sure yours looks nicer than mine, but that's just like another way you can do this. And this last one is inspired by a temporary tattoo I saw on Andrea Russet's Instagram. I don't know, I just thought it was really cool. So moving on to the next notebooks, this one is like an ombre spray paint one. Again, I love these composition notebooks because they are so cheap and just like easy to get a hold of, and all I did was spray paint the bottom with light pink, and then I went over the very bottom layer with gold, and I just think this looks really cool and it's so easy to do. The last notebook I have for you is this like cork one, and I just got this from Target. And then I got a fabric doily, and you can get these at like fabric stores and craft stores. I got mine from Joann, and they're really cheap. They're only like $2, which is really cool. And I just love how they look. I think they're just, I don't know, the words are tough. I have not slept. I'm very tired right now. But anyways, I'm just hot gluing it onto the cover of the notebook. And then I left a little on the side so I could like tuck it on the inside just to kind of secure it a little bit more. You could also probably use Mod Podge for this, but I just thought the hot glue would hold a little bit better. And that is it. It's so cute. So now we're going to move on to DIY backpacks. So I've done a similar DIY before, but I wanted to show all of you guys that are new to my channel how to fabric transfer because it's really easy and you can do basically whatever you want. So I'm doing one inspired by Melanie Martinez's Crybaby album because it's like my favorite ever. I got fabric transfer paper. You can get it from Walmart, Joann Craft Store, Michaels, wherever. And all I did was type out Crybaby on my computer because I love that album so much. And all I did was print it onto the transfer paper, and then you just want to peel off the back layer of the transfer paper and then use a piece of parchment paper to cover it and then just iron it on. I normally press it for about 30 seconds and check it, and you can kind of tell if it's completely sealed or not. And I did two different versions of this just to give you guys different ideas, but obviously you could do whatever you want to transfer on it. So it's really easy. All you have to do is print the image, cut it out, peel off that back layer, cover it with parchment paper, and then iron it for 30 seconds. It probably seems like a lot, but all of them come with like directions too, so it should be really easy for you guys to do, and I think it's just a really cool way to customize a backpack. So I leave it all behind. So this last DIY is how to spruce up little binder dividers, and I just love this DIY. I think it's so adorable. So this DIY is super easy because all you're doing is finding images and basically printing them, which is awesome. So I went online and I just found a few cute images that I liked and I put them in a Word document. Then I went to this website and it's basically like a little speech bubble generator. Like you can type whatever you want and it will pop out the image for you. So all I did was type in all of my classes and then I copied them and just pasted them over top of the images I already had. I hope that makes sense. I'm sorry, I feel like I'm really struggling to explain myself today just because I am super, super tired. But all the images I use, like the little heart and the lips and the pineapple, I will have it all linked down below so you guys can use the same ones if you want to. And then I'll also have the website with the little speech bubble generator as well. But basically, all you have to do is copy, paste, and print, and then you can put them on your binder dividers. And again, like the previous DIYs, this is probably easier with sticker paper, but you could definitely just do it with regular printer paper as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you later. Bye!